What is going on, guys? Sage Arts here, and today I'm bringing a new series to the channel of Demon Slayer Battles. I haven't really thought of a cool name for it yet, so for now I'm just going to call it Demon Slayer Battles. But the first two people that we have going up against each other, we have Gi Tomioka and Kyojuro Rengoku. By the end of the video, there'll be a winner after comparing the two's abilities and power at their strongest points. I'll also leave a poll in the top right corner so you guys can vote on who you think would be victorious if the two were to fight. And quick disclaimer, there will be manga spoilers throughout the video, so if you aren't caught up to the latest Demon Slayer chapters, make sure to click off the video and let's get right into it. So to start this off, due to the current events of Demon Slayer, it would only make sense that we look at Rengoku first. Kyojuro Rengoku is the eldest son of the former Hashira, Shinjuro Rengoku, and he is the most recent Flame Hashira of the Demon Slayer Corps. Being a pillar, obviously Rengoku is very strong, but even among the Hashira, his strength is something special. But before that, let's get into how Rengoku got so strong. Growing up, Rengoku was taught by his mother that it was his duty to protect the weak, since he was born to be stronger than others. A way of thinking that would stay with him for the rest of his life and would shape the man he would grow up to be. He was also taught swordsmanship by his father at a young age, but once his father Shinjuro suddenly gave up the blade and said that neither him or Kyojuro could ever become great people due to his fixation of the Breath of the Sun users and how everyone who isn't one is destined to be inferior, Kyojuro, despite his father's negativity and hatred towards the Demon Slayer Corps, trained himself into a pillar using the Book of the Flame Breath and by working extremely hard. As a pillar, Rengoku was a master swordsman and had enhanced strength and speed. Being so fast that during the Demon Train arc, Tanjiro, despite being a trained Demon Slayer, he couldn't even follow his movements, and his speed even caused tremors to occur. And despite his amazing natural abilities, Kyojuro was a user of the Breath of Flames. His techniques consisted of the Breath of Flames' first style, Sea of Fire, in which Rengoku charged at his opponent with blinding speed whilst decapitating them. Breath of Flame's second style, Ascending Blazing Sky, a rising slash which he used to cut up and move free Akaza's arm in half, a third style which is unknown, his fourth style, Wave of Blazing Flames, where he spins in a circular motion deflecting enemy attacks, his fifth style, Flame Tiger, which Rengoku used to contest up and move free Akaza's destructive kill war style, the next three styles, 6 through 8, are unknown, and next is Rengoku's strongest technique, his 9th style Purgatory, which is a technique which begins from a high stance into a dashing slash, which carved a deep impression into the ground after Rengoku used it. Rengoku was so strong that due to him alone, there was no casualties on the train. Literally because of him, over 200 people survived the attack, and despite him using so many techniques just before encountering Akaza, he didn't even seem remotely exhausted. Rengoku then fought Akaza alone because out of the other slayers present, he was the only one who could even contest Akaza. It was even stated by Inosuke that the two were on another dimension. And although Rengoku was injured and even had Akaza's hand straight through his stomach, he kept on fighting and was close to taking off his head. Though shortly after the battle he gave into his injuries and died, he managed to protect everyone and fulfill his duties as a Hashira. And the reactions coming from his fellow Hashira of shock at his death despite coming up against the Upper Moon further shows how respected he was and how strong he was as a pillar. And Rengoku never even awakened his Demon Slayer mark and was still this strong. Lastly, when Akaza saw and complimented Rengoku's battle spirit, he said that Rengoku was approaching Supreme Territory, meaning he was close to obtaining the Sifu World, which we see Tanjiro use later down the line, which was also used by his father and the original Breath of the Sun user, Yoriichi Tsujikuni. Rengoku definitely carried out his duty to the end, and he really goes to show that with hard work, you can do whatever you set your mind to. His mother told him that he was born strong and should protect others, while on the other hand, his father told him that he wouldn't amount to anything, and he wasn't a chosen one just because he wasn't a Breath of the Sun user. But Rengoku defied all the odds and became an unmovable pillar who definitely left his mark in the series. Now, let's move on to Gi Tomioka. Gi was introduced to us in episode 1 of Kimetsu no Yaiba, shortly after Tanjiro's family had been massacred and Nezuko had been turned into a demon. Gi was the first ever Demon Slayer shown in this series, and the first Hashira we ever meet. He was also the one who put Tanjiro on the path of a slayer by sending him to meet the former Water Hashira, Urokodaki. Gi is shown throughout this series to be a very loyal and courageous person, as his name suggests. Despite his reserved nature, he takes pride in his duty as a Demon Slayer and does his job to the best of his ability. It was even revealed during the Hashira meeting that he put his life on the line for Nezuko and Tanjiro, as he would commit seppuku should Nezuko ever eat a human, thus showing how far he would go for the Kamado siblings and people he cares about. Despite Giyu being a Hashira, around chapter 130 of the manga, we see that Giyu, due to his past, doesn't believe he's fit to be a Demon Slayer at all, as he technically didn't pass the final selection exam, as he and everyone else who took the exam that year were saved by Sabito. And as a result, Sabito was the only one who failed and ended up dying, leading Giyu to feel guilty about his best friend's death. But after talking to Tanjiro, Giyu realizes that Sabito and his sister wanted him to live on, and he would do his best to do so. That's also why half of Giyu's hierarchy is Sabito's and the others is his sister's. It's a tribute to them. We also get to see demonstrations of Giyu's strength during the Mount Natsugumo arc, when Giyu saves Inosuke and easily kills the father spider demon he was struggling with, and when Giyu was able to cut Law Moon 5's head off in the blink of an eye. As a pillar, Giyu is a master swordsman and has enhanced speed and endurance, and he is a breath of water user. He was taught water breathing by the former Hashira Urokodaki Sakonji, and this breathing technique allows the user to increase the amount of oxygen in their blood, making their speed and power equal to that of a demon. His techniques consist of the Breath of Water first style, Water Surface Slash. Next is the Breath of Water second style, Water Wheel, where the swordsman jumps and spins their body while slashing. Then we have his Breath of Water third style, Dance of the Rapid Current, where the swordsman swings his blade at the opponent in a way that mimics waves. Next is his Breath of Water fourth style, Striking Tide, where he makes multiple slashes in a row in a flowing manner. We then have his Breath of Water fifth style, the Merciful Rain of a Dry Day, which is a technique which kills the target with little to no pain. Next is his Breath of Water 6 style, Twisting Whirlpool, where the swordsman violently twists his upper and lower body, causing a whirlpool which cuts anything inside it. We then have his Breath of Water 7th style, Piercing Raindrop, a fast and precise stab which is the fastest Breath of Water technique. His Breath of Water 8th style, Waterfall Jar, where the user cuts the target vertically. His Breath of Water 9th style, Waterfall Splash, which is a technique ideal for fighting where there are no footholds. Then his Breath of Water 10th style, the Dragon of Change, which is a continuous string of attacks that increase in power with every rotation. And finally, the style created by Giyu himself, which is exclusive only to him. His 11th style, LOL, which Giyu uses to disable incoming attacks. Giyu's strength has always been clear throughout the show, as he's never been seen to overexert himself. For example, he was able to subdue Nezuko easily with a chop at the beginning of the series. He was also able to kill the father spider demon with ease, and also Law Moon 5 Ruri. However, once we reach the Dimensional Infinity Fortress arc, we finally get to see Giyu's true strength at full force. This happens by Giyu and Tanjiro entering into a 2-on-1 battle against Upper Moon 3 Akaza. As the battle begins, Tanjiro manages to hold himself in small encounters with Akaza and says he can fight. Giyu tries to attack Akaza with his Breath of Water first style, only for it to be countered by Akaza's Destructive Kill War style, which Giyu then counters with LOL. Akaza even remarks that it had been 50 years since he ran into a water pillar as strong as Giyu, and he had never seen the technique LOL used before, which began to excite him. And he also asks for Giyu's name, which is what Akaza does when he comes against strong people. Giyu manages to cut up Akaza's arm while Akaza was trying to go for the kill on Tanjiro. They then exchange blows and Akaza sends Giyu flying with his destructive leg style flowing Light Flash, keeping him out of the fight for a short period of time. And a quick side note, I'm going to try not to mention Tanjiro here when it's not necessary. Once Giyu rises, he states it's been a while since he's been overwhelmed, and due to the heat of the battle, he awakens his Demon Slayer mark. His speed increases tremendously and he trades blows with Akaza again, but only manages to inflict shallow wounds, despite the power up. And in the process of attacking, he's also being hurt by Akaza. Only for it then to be stated by Tanjiro that despite Giyu's speed increase, Akaza had already matched it. And Tanjiro, while analysing Akaza, jumps into the battle again, but Akaza still has both of them on the ropes. Moments later, we see Giyu using his temp style Dragon of Change, but he's still being completely overwhelmed by Akaza, who has learned to anticipate his attacks. Akaza ends up snapping Giyu's sword in half and is about to deliver the finishing blow, but Giyu is saved by Tanjiro, whose Demon Slayer mark is activated and is in the see-through world state. Tanjiro ends up chopping Akaza's head off, but in the end, Akaza dies due to him losing the will to fight and essentially self-destructing. Otherwise, Tanjiro and Giyu would have lost. But regardless, they both put up a good fight. Now, after going through defeats and abilities of both Giyu, Tomioka, and Kyojuro Rengoku, the main element which influences my decision as to who is stronger is definitely both their fights against Akaza, which is why the person who I believe is stronger is definitely Rengoku. Kyojuro, upon fighting Akaza, was fighting alone the whole time. Prior to the fight, he had used many techniques to save people on the train, and he had no Demon Slayer mark, but was still able to accomplish all this. He managed to inflict more damage to Akaza as a whole than Giyu, and was still fighting and almost decapitated him with fatal injuries. And he was also praised more during the fight with Akaza, and was even asked to become a demon on multiple occasions, which Akaza never once said to Giyu. And Akaza even said Kyojuro was close to Supreme Territory, also known as the See-Through World. Furthermore, in chapter 148, Akaza said he was glad Rengoku died that night, as he likely wouldn't have been able to get any stronger, meaning Rengoku is likely at the peak level of strength a human can reach, despite not having a Demon Slayer mark. Also, the fact that Kyojuro was fighting Akaza alone, but Giyu and Tanjiro were working together, which was basically Akaza against two pillars, since Giyu said that Tanjiro's power matched that of a pillar, further shows that Kyojuro was stronger. And Tanjiro and Giyu were saving each other from being killed from fatal attacks many times, so they both could have died or lost their strength much earlier in the fight with Akaza. And the only point I could actually take out of Kyojuro's favour is the fact that Akaza fled from him due to the sun rising and not from fear of his head being cut off. But it still doesn't change the fact that with a hole through his stomach, Kyojuro was able to keep him at bay and get halfway through his neck. So in conclusion, the winner of this battle would be Kyojuro Rengoku. Well, that's it for the video, guys. I'll have a poll in the top right corner so you can vote for who you think is stronger. If you agree or disagree with me, let me know in the comment section down below. I'll also have a vote for the next two characters I do a video on. I plan on doing Tanjiro versus Zenitsu, but I guess comment who you want to see down below. And if there's tons of likes on one in particular, I'll take it into consideration. But make sure to follow me on Twitter at SageOwls_ so you always keep up with what I'm doing. Like and subscribe if you're new for more Demon Slayer content. We're on the road for 10k subscribers. And yeah, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.